Let's start the chapter on cylinders and spheres, and the very first topic that we are going to do is the thin cylinder under internal pressure. This means we have a cylinder whose thickness is very less as compared to its diameter, and it is being subjected upon by a internal pressure. So let us say this is the cylinder. Okay, the thickness is very less as compared to the diameter, and it is being subjected upon by internal pressure like this and like this. Okay, due to this there are two kind of stresses that are produced in this cylinder, and you can see these two diagrams over here. So we'll go to these diagrams one by one. Let me name this diagram as 1 and this diagram as 2. Now, due to this internal pressure, the two stresses, or before I go into that, just, you know, because of this pressure, there are two ways in which this cylinder can be strained. It can be elongated due to this pressure, which is in the direction of its length. So this is the longitudinal pressure direction. And due to this pressure, it can increase in its circumference. Okay, so the increase in its circumference is resisted by the stress sigma 1, which is also called circumferential stress. So sigma 1 is the circumferential stress. Circumferential stress. It is also known as hoop stress. Okay. And the longitudinal elongation would be resisted by the production of sigma 2, which is called the longitudinal stress. So this is longitudinal stress. Okay. So this is a very important point to first of all understand, that due to the application of pressure inside that thin cylinder, you will have production of two stresses, one circumferential or hoop, and second is longitudinal. So let's first of all analyze what happens with the hoop stress, that is sigma 1. Now if you look at this diagram over here and this diagram, the pressure is trying to increase the circumference of the cylinder because it's a circular cross section. Alright. So when you come over here, when you cut a section through it, this pressure is trying to push, or you know, it's trying to burst open the entire cylinder because it is joined at this surface via welding or via riveting, whatever it is. So it will be okay, so this is how the circumference will increase. It will try and become oval like this. Now, why only this surface is resisting it? This surface over here is trying to resist this ovality creation in the cylinder. And on this surface, you will have the application of the hoop stress. Okay, so if you equate the two stress forces, the stress force on this surface, there are two surfaces, the stress force on this surface is sigma into T into L. T is the thickness. Okay, so sigma 1 into T into L is the stress force due to this circumferential stress. And because there are two surfaces, so you will have 2 into sigma 1 into T into L. Now this has to be balanced by the pressure force. Okay, now the pressure force that we will be taking is the pressure force on this projected area. So the projected area, let us say this is the circle or the semicircle. The projection of the semicircle is nothing but the diameter. So this length over here, this is the diameter. So the projected area will become diameter into length. Okay, so you have pressure into diameter into length. So you can strike off length. So from here you can find out sigma 1. So sigma 1 will be equal to P into D upon 2T. That is the value of the hoop stress. That is the mathematical expression to calculate hoop stress. Okay. Now after hoop stress, let's come to this figure. That is for the calculation of the longitudinal stress. Now you have a pressure inside the cylinder which is trying to burst it along the length. It is trying to elongate it. Okay. Now because the cross section of the cylinder is circular, so the area which is resisting this pressure is pi by 4 into d square. If I multiply this area with the pressure being applied, then it becomes the pressure force. For this equilibrium, this pressure force has to be equal to the resisting force. So the resisting force, if you look at this, this is the area which will resist the bursting of the cylinder, you can say across or along the length. So this is the stress on this area. What is this area? Area is pi d into t. Okay. So this would become area is pi d into t, and if you multiply this with sigma 2, it becomes the resistive force. So from here you can just strike off pi and d, and sigma 2 will be equal to pd upon 4t. So this is the longitudinal stress. Okay, longitudinal stress. So this is how you calculate the two stresses in a thin cylinder under internal pressure. The important formula to note down over here is this for hoop stress and this for longitudinal stress. I hope you understood this. Now let's move on to the next video and talk about a sphere instead of a cylinder.